Welcome to my YouTube channel. Today I am going to start the current affairs in English of the 5th November 2022. So we will discuss about the current affairs of the 5th of November 2022. First of all, we will discuss about the questions that I have given yesterday in the last of video. The question was the which among the following was used at the motto for Census of India 2011. Option A is the Our Future, Our Country. Option B is the Our Country, Our Census. Option C is the People of India, Our Census. And option D is the Our Census, Our Future. So the motto for Census of India 2011 is the Our Census, Our Future. So correct option is option D, Our Census, Our Future is the motto for Census of India 2011. Next, we will start the National Current Affairs News. So, in the National Current Affairs News, first is the Ganga Utsav. Ganga Utsav, it is the river festival that is to be celebrated on the 4th of November. And this Ganga Utsav is organized by the Ministry of Jal Shakti. It is organized by the Ministry of Jal Shakti. And this Ganga Utsav, it is the river festival 2022 is organized by the Ministry of Jal Shakti on 4th of November 2022. Next is the Union Agriculture Minister organized the National Natural Farming Mission meeting, which is chaired by the Union Agriculture Minister Narendra Singh Tomar. So the first National Natural Farming Mission is organized at the Krishi Bhavan, which is chaired by the Union Agriculture Minister Narendra Singh Tomar, in which the NMNF portal has been launched by the Narendra Singh Tomar. Next is the PM Narendra Modi has declared the Mangad Dham National Monument as the National Monument. So PM Narendra Modi has declared the Mangad Dham as the National Monument in which is located in the Banswara districts in Rajasthan. And Mangad Dham, it is the symbol for tenacity and sacrifice of tribals of the Rajasthan, Gujarat, Maharashtra and Madhya Pradesh. So Mangad Dham is now declared as the National Monuments by the PM Narendra Modi. Next is the according to CMI. CMI full form is Center for Monitoring Indian Economy. So according to CMI, the unemployment rate has increased from 6.43 to 7.77% in the October month because of the rural joblessness rate after the Kharif harvest season. The unemployment rate is increased and is at the 7.77% in October. The data has been released by the Center for Monitoring Indian Economy. Next is the PM Narendra Modi has inaugurated the Global Investors Meet that is organized in the Karnataka, that is Invest Karnataka 2022. So PM Narendra Modi has inaugurated the Invest Karnataka, that is the Global Investors Meeting that is organized in the Karnataka, mainly for attracting the investors and setting up the development agenda for the next decade. For that, the Invest Karnataka, it is an event that is organized in the Karnataka state. Next is the Finance Minister launches the biggest ever coal mines auction, that is of the 141 mines. And these auction of 141 mines will benefit the 12 states directly. And she has also said that there should be more investment in the coal production and gasification projects. So the auction will be done to 141 coal mines. So gender wealth gap in APSC is largest in India, that is at 64%. So according to the survey, India has the widest gender wealth gap, that is 64%. This is mainly due to higher burden of caregiving responsibility. Because of that, India has the widest gender wealth gap. Next is the Shyam Saran, who is the first voter of independent India, has cast their vote for the Himachal Pradesh through postal ballot. So the first voter of independent India has cast their vote through the postal ballot. His name is Shyam Saran Negi. Next is the Adani New Industries had installed the India's largest wind turbine, that is taller than the Statue of Unity. And this tallest turbine has been constructed at the Mundra in Gujarat as a part of promoting the renewable energy. And this wind turbine is taller than the Statue of Unity. So, India's largest wind turbine has been constructed by the Adani New Industry Limited at the Mundra in Gujarat. The Adani New Industry Limited founded in 1988 and its headquarters is located in Ahmedabad. And the owner of Adani New Industry Limited is Gautam Adani. Next is the, we will discuss about the appointment related news. So, Vishal Kapoor has been named as the CEO of the Energy Efficiency Services. So, Vishal Kapoor has been named as the or appointed as the CEO of the Energy Efficiency Services Limited, EESL. Next is the V.R. Krishna Gupta. V.R. Krishna Gupta has been appointed as the chairman of the BPCL. So, V.R. Krishna Gupta has been appointed as the chairman and managing director of Bharat Petroleum Corporation Limited, BPCL. BPCL was founded in the year 1952. Its headquarters is located in Mumbai. Next, we shall discuss about the sports related news. So, in a sports related news, the Kerala will host the Track Asia Cup 2022 cycling tournament, and that tournament was held from 25th of November to 28th of November. So, Kerala will host the Track Asia Cup 2022 cycling tournament. Next is the In Asian Continental Chess Championship, two chess player from the India has won the title, that is R. Pragnananda and P.B. Nandidha. R. Pragnananda and P.B. Nandidha has won the title of Asian Continental Chess Championship. So, the two players, that is R. Pragnananda and P.B. Nandidha, has won the Asian Continental Chess Championship, that is organized in the New Delhi. So, this is the current affairs news of the 5th of November. Next, in last, we will give one question. So, today question is the Battle of Plassey. Battle of Plassey was fought in which year? Option A is the 1757, option B the 1782, option C the 1748, and option D the 1764. So, please give the answer of this question in the comment section. So, thanks for watching my video. Please like, subscribe and share my video.